Hi, welcome back to The Shtick. We're still in the studio on Zoom to Mission Beach in FNQ with Jayne Josem. Hello, Jayne.
Hi, thanks for having me.
It's my pleasure. You've never been on The Shtick. It's ridiculous.
I know. I had to escape Melbourne and to far north Queensland for you to trap me down.
I got you. Yeah, so you are the museum director and CEO of the Melbourne Holocaust Museum. Yay!
Newly renamed, and in fact, we're just going through the name change right now from the Jewish Holocaust Centre. That's why I've escaped and let everyone, everyone's going crazy in the office trying to change everything overnight.
And you've been the senior curator since 2002.
Yeah, I've been at the centre for 20 years, according to my LinkedIn profile. But 3 years ago, I became the director, and it's been an incredible journey the last few years, not just COVID, but, you know, rebuilding our centre, pulling down the old building, and we're almost about to get the keys to the new building to start the internal fit-out. So it's a very exciting time.
Where's the new building going to be?
It's in the same place as the old building at 13 Selwyn Street. Yeah, we've kept part of it. Yeah. Yeah, we've kept part of the facade. It was a heritage listed building and built all around it. And on the same footprint, we've just really massively expanded the amount of floor space so that we can just keep educating more and more visitors, students, adults, anyone, and hold events, all sorts of things. We are, you know, very excited later this year to be reopening.
You haven't set a date yet at this stage?
Yeah, well, COVID's kind of a tricky one because the supply chain issues and, you know, staff shortages have impacted us massively. But look, later this year, early next year, we'll let you know as soon as we know.
Keep it open. You've got a master's in a Master of Arts in history at Monash?
Yep, I do, public history. That's where I got involved in the Holocaust Museum as a volunteer at first whilst doing that MA. It was a really good course. And the Holocaust Museum was, I didn't realise that I would be there for 20 years when I first walked in the door. But, it's an amazing place. And when you start working with the survivors and you just share their passion to convey the tragic history, but also they're incredible people who want to share, who want to make the world a better place. So, you know, it's a bit infectious, wanting their energy and wanting to help them share those important stories. So,
yeah, you're also head of collections.
Oh, yeah, I was. I've handed that over. And Dr. Anna Hirsch is now the manager of collections and research. And excellent job. And it's been incredible, in fact, during COVID, as people have been stuck at home, the things that they've found and have started to want to share with us. We thought, you know, COVID would be, you know, a quiet time for the collections, and they had enough on their hands packing everything up to move out. But yeah, we've been amassing material during COVID, which is incredible. And there's still more in the community, and we really encourage community members to come forward with material before it's too late. Before it's too late for them to learn what the stories are, to understand the stories behind the documents that they find in their back drawers.
Yeah, well, you've got an article in the Australian Jewish News this week on page 19, which is very, very timely because we've got Yom HaShoah coming up, which is the day of commemorating and remembering the Holocaust, which is going to be on the 27th of April.
Yep. So Yom HaShoah is always a very important community commemoration where people gather together to obviously in different ways to commemorate that. We partner with the JCCV for the communal celebration, which is on Wednesday evening, called Remembering Together. It is going to be virtual again this year. And the idea is we're encouraging people to sort of gather at home with family, with friends, and watch the event together as a family group and, you know, have a discussion afterwards. Holocaust survivor Charles German is a keynote speaker, And his tale is really incredible. He was born in Chernivtsi, which was then Romania. But if you look at the map today, it's part of Ukraine. And so his story, he ended up in a ghetto in Mogilev, also Ukraine. So his story is kind of just by chance very important to be retelling today with the events going on there. So there's that, but there's actually a number of different community events that we're partnering with, because as far as we're concerned, we just want to encourage people to remember in whatever way suits them. So Tuesday night at Memo Music Hall, there's an event called Uprising, Songs of Survival, which the Museum of Inherited Memories have put on. That has sold out, but I think it can be streamed. The Melbourne Hebrew Congregation actually have just announced an event on Thursday at 5 o'clock, if I'm correct, at the Toorak Synagogue with Josh Frydenberg as keynote speaker and Nina Bassat, Holocaust survivor, also giving her part of her testimony. So there's that event. There's FOJAM on Thursday night have, I think it's got When Women Speak of War is what it's called, and that's been curated by Maria Tumarkin, who was also born in Ukraine, and so I'm sure it'll touch a little bit on the issues there as well. So there's plenty of ways that people can take the opportunity to remember the Holocaust.
Yeah, well, the article in the Jewish News basically says, this Yom HaShoah, commit to three simple words, and that is, I will remember, which is really, we want to perpetuate the memory but not act as victims.
Yeah, I was, I think it sort of seemed a bit obvious to say, oh, I will remember. And I was thinking about a lot of Jewish people in particular just take Holocaust commemoration for granted. I'm not sure if that's the right way to say it. Or, you know, they think that's somewhere that's for their grandparents. We don't need to do it. Or some think we don't want to be defined by the Holocaust. We want to move on. You know, we need to not keep going on about the Holocaust. But, you know, that is really dangerous. And at our museum, we have these little cards that say, I will remember, dot, dot, dot. And the students fill things in. And they're really powerful messages. And we must, as a community, lead the way in Holocaust commemoration, because if we don't actively remember it, you know, others won't either. So that was the message.
Well, thank you so much for allowing me to connect with you finally, Jayne.
Thank you. I just want to, one other thing that my team will not be happy if I don't mention, that Yom HaShoah is also our annual fundraising appeal at the Melbourne Holocaust Museum. And we do need community support to keep teaching students every day. We even though the building isn't yet ready, we are continuing to educate from our temporary home. And we have been educating throughout COVID, online, on site. And it requires a lot of energy and a lot of effort to continue to do that, and we really value the community support at this time. And it is great how much the community do support us, but I just need to mention that as well.
Wonderful. Yeah, well, we all need support, especially financial. We've all been going through a difficult time the last couple of years financially, because we just take things for granted, and then all of a sudden the tap has been turned off. And that we need to doubly work towards keeping it going. And you've done a wonderful job, Jayne. I must commend you and the way the Holocaust Centre keeps going and educating the wider public about the Holocaust. And I wish you well. And I will remember, as we know, we all have family members who didn't survive. And so enjoy your time in Mission Beach.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah, it's good to get a little mini break. It is good to get away. But thank you, and thanks for supporting the Melbourne Holocaust Museum.
I always do. And we'll say farewell now. Say shalom.
Shalom.
And we wish peace on all the world.
We do indeed. Thank you.
And we'll be back next week with more Shtick, because that's what we do.